The great thing about a micro inverter is that you can power half of a dishwasher even with your small PV system on balcony or on your garage. With a standard inverter, the full load will be on that inverter. If it's not able to handle that, you keep the dirty dishes. Moreover, you would have to bring that inverter plus the battery to each consumer as you need it.
No!
So be smart. Use the distribution network that is already in your house and use a micro inverter. Hello and welcome back to Energy Home Do It Yourself. I'm Norbert, energy engineer. In this video number 101, I explain first how to use a micro inverter in the standard way with a single or double PV panel. After that, we continue the journey powering the micro inverter from a battery that's charged by that same solar panel. In video 100, I explained already the advantage of this battery, avoiding that excess energy goes unused into the public grid for no money. And then later, you need to repurchase this energy for a full price. Let that be the past. This sell-buy swindle is already a disappointment for many owners of a full-fledged PV roof. From now on, all your harvested energy remains in your house. After this video, you will still have the problem that power can go through the energy meter in the wrong direction, causing possible problems with the electricity supplier, or in the best case practically give away your energy for nothing. But with a bit of patience, it will be solved. You can start implementing today what I propose in this video and enjoy already in spring 2025 a small but practical solar system that can reach all your devices in your house. Then wait the videos here thereafter. It will make a system that automatically reduces the power that goes from your battery into your grid, so that it will always be less than what you consume. Therefore, the power will not go outside your home. Yes, I go in small steps, but will arrive there where you want to be too. First, because I am too excited to let it be as it is today. Second, because I know as an electrotechnical engineer that it is possible. But the devil is in the details, and I will figure that out for you. With DIY, you can realize things that are not on the market, and if they are, they come with a big price, and you will have to buy also their own accessories from that moment on. Every video may seem to you a small step, but the last video took me already 34 hours, including research and laboratory time. If you support me, I can dedicate nearly the double of that time to energy innovation in your home. Where do you find a channel that focuses just on this subject, so that you know what you get? So if at the end you think you have learned a lot, then put your thumb up, subscribe to the channel and share it with your friends that need this info. Okay, I hope you agree that we tackle innovation in small steps. So what will give this video? We will be able to 1. Use a microinverter in the standard way between the PV module and the wall plug. 2. Control the power from the battery to the home grid, turning a simple knob like the volume on your old stereo installation. And this battery is charged with an affordable solar charger from your PV panel. I just connected it between the PV panel and the home grid. I also used a standard household energy meter, but in reverse. Normally these meters can detect power flowing back into the grid, but if you flip the direction of this meter, it will show how much the microinverter is sending into the house. I can compare that with the reading on the house consumption meter and check that my production is always less than the consumption. If you don't have this meter, then you should really watch this video, because it's a great psychological help to save energy with an investment of only 20 euros. You have your consumption always under your eyes. Obviously, your consumption can change many times without knowing it. So this would force the solar energy to the outside of the home. but it should be automatic. I already told you that this will follow in another video. For the time being, you can just feed so much power into your grid that it stays below the base load, which is 50 watts in our home. A very good idea is to put the exit of your microinverter together with one consuming device or more in a multi-socket box and switch that all together to your grid. For example, a TV, computer, charging device for two, e-bike or e-car. They have a pretty stable consumption and your PV battery can go on discharging for a long time, so there is space inside it for the solar energy of the next sunny day. Be careful with these contacts. This is only for testing. Let's return to the battery. Last week, I showed how the microinverter works when connected to a battery. Limiting the current with a car lamp. This behaves as a resistance with a positive temperature coefficient and is therefore intrinsically safe. However, it consumes energy. This week I am adding a PWM controller to control the current with minimal loss. Instead of automatic control to this PWM unit, I use this week a simple analog potentiometer, a turning knob, to adjust the current going from the battery to the inverter. And this allows me to test the system safely, step by step. The microinverter can power real household loads, like a dishwasher, smaller devices or altogether. That makes the solar experience seamless with your usual life. And in case of a blackout, the microwave inverter will stop working, like also a usual roof PV system. But you can use a standard affordable inverter on the same battery to pass the next few hours off grid. It's an important milestone that you can use a small solar system to contribute to your overall consumption at home. But you will now also be able to shift the consumption of your excess solar energy to another moment, making count every hour of sun. In order to make this simple version without monitoring of your home's consumption still practical, I find this idea of sticking the microinverter plug together with some consumers together into a multi-plug box very practical. It will guarantee that you have a period with a significant and useful load that will avoid that the energy goes from your microinverter into the public grid. At the end of the video, you will find a list of consumers that are very stable in their consumption, not like a washing machine or a fridge, which have a program or a thermostat. Give me other good examples of such stable consumers in the comments. In a future video, I hope this will be quick, I will add automation, so the system increases the battery power that goes into your grid only when the house needs it. That will be based on live energy flow measurements that go into the PWM controller. And remember, you don't need a big system to make the difference, to start making a difference. See you next week. I will try to dedicate that to the automatic microinverter. And wait a minute before switching off. I wish you good energy.